was a fairy tale, you were the prince. I used to be a damsel in distress. You took me by the hand and you picked me up at six. Today it was a fairy tale.
Thank you. I've known the bride and groom since we were in grade school, but I remember the first day that I realized Courtney and Austin were becoming a thing. In agronomy class our junior year, I sat on Austin's right and Courtney was on his left. One day I noticed that Austin always kept his hand underneath the table. And every time I looked, it would be closer and closer to Courtney, hoping that she'd get the subtle hint to hold his hand. And by gosh, one day she must have, because they were holding hands every chance they got in that class.
Courtney and I have so many memories, I didn't even know where to begin. So I decided I would give some advice to Austin from his bride's best friend. The first one, she is going to make you run. I don't mean a simple 2 mile run. I mean, hey, we can just run 6 miles today. But because you love her, you will slowly die while trying to run 6 miles. Sometimes she is going to let stressful situations control her day, but just taking the time to listen to her or running 6 miles with her is all you need in order to show her everything will be okay. She is going to make you laugh. This girl is full of amazing jokes and funny moments that are going to keep you laughing for a lifetime. She's going to hold you in the hardest of times. Ooh. When you are struggling at work, or some sort of fallout with a family member or friend comes up, she's going to be there for you. All you need to say is you had a tough day, and she will hold you while you talk, or well, in my case, cry. Her faith in God is going to inspire you every day. She has been through many ups and downs, yet she still leans on Him in every situation. She's going to urge you to be a better Christian.
Austin and Courtney, way back when you guys told your mother and I that you were going to get married, I told myself that I was going to make a list of qualities to look for in someone before you decide to marry them. Well, I finished that list last night. The list is called Marry Someone Who. Marry someone who loves you for you. Who loves you for who you are and doesn't want to change you. Marry someone who doesn't care whether you earn $100 or $10,000 a month. Marry someone who makes you laugh when you want to cry. Marry someone who would rather hurt you with the truth than keep you happy with a lie. Marry someone who accepts your fears and helps you to fight them. Marry someone who laughs with you and never at you. Marry someone with whom you lose track of time. Marry someone who supports you and lifts you up no matter how many times you fall. Marry someone who doesn't mind admitting when they are wrong. And last but not least, marry someone who allows you to be your weird self without judging you. With all the advice, I would like to say how proud I am of both of you and that Carol and I love both of you. I also want to say thank you to Ardell and Katie, Jimmy and Kara, and John and Sandy for welcoming my daughter into your family. And we love all of you, and I'm going to quit before I start crying like a little baby.
But I'll be a shelter through the wind and the rain, and we'll